A meddling family member trying to help a relative get married is the plot of numerous books and movies. But what if instead of trying to marry off a relative, someone wanted to create a provision to prevent his or her family member from ever getting married? We'll see whether restraint-on-marriage provisions were valid in Lewis v. Searles. Letitia Lewis died in 1926. In her will, Letitia devised her property to her niece, Hattie Lewis, so long as Hattie remained single and unmarried. However, if Hattie ever got married, then the property would be equally divided between Hattie, Letitia's other niece, Letitia LaForge, and Letitia's nephew, James Lewis. Letitia's will didn't mention anything about Hattie's death or what would happen to Hattie's interest in the property after Hattie died. LaForge and James died after Letitia's will was probated. However, LaForge and James each had children. 40 years after Letitia's will was probated, Hattie filed suit for declaratory judgment that she owned the property in fee simple. Even though Hattie had never married, Hattie also claimed that the restriction against marriage in Letitia's will was void. James's children, represented by Janice Searles, counterclaimed and argued that Hattie only had a life estate in the property. The trial court held that Letitia only intended to give Hattie a life estate. After Hattie died, the property would vest in fee simple, with 1/3 interest to Hattie, 1/3 interest to LaForge's descendants, and 1/3 interest to James's descendants. Hattie appealed to the Missouri Supreme Court.